Dear students, welcome in new session all of you. Today I, Mr. NJ Jha, am going to explain the first chapter of mathematics class 10th. That's name is real numbers. Students, before to start this chapter, first of all I want to explain some definitions of important terms related to this chapter. First term is natural numbers. I hope that everybody knows about the natural numbers. Natural numbers are the numbers which are also called counting numbers, and everybody knows that counting numbers start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, up to infinity. So, natural numbers are the numbers that we count in mathematics. So, starting from 1, 1 to infinity, these all numbers are called natural numbers. Natural number is denoted by capital N. This number is 1, but we cannot define the highest natural number. Now, come on, second term, that is whole number. Whole numbers. If we include 0 in the family of natural numbers, then that become whole numbers. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to infinity. These are the whole numbers. So the smallest whole number is 0, but we cannot define the highest whole number. As we know, all natural numbers are whole numbers, but all whole numbers cannot be natural numbers. Whole number is denoted by capital W. Now come on, the third term, integers. I hope that you may have studied about this in junior class. Integers. Usually integers are denoted by capital Z. Integers are the numbers which are negative, positive, including zero. So, we cannot define the smallest integer, and also we cannot define the highest integer. But some are negative integers, some are positive integers, and zero is neither positive nor negative. So we cannot find the highest integer and the lowest integer. Now, come on, the next term, even numbers. Everybody knows even numbers are the multiples of 2, and odd numbers are not the multiples of 2. If we divide even numbers by 2, then in each and every situation the remainder will be 1. So the lowest even number is 2 and the lowest odd number is 1. Now prime numbers. In class 9th I had explained about the prime numbers. Prime numbers are the numbers which have only two factors, 1 and the number itself. So, 1 is neither prime nor composite. So, the smallest prime number is 2, but 2 is the only even number that is prime. After that, all prime numbers are odd numbers. So, some examples of prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, etc. So, the smallest prime number is 2, but we cannot define the highest prime number. Now, come on, the next topic, next point, that is composite number. Those numbers in natural numbers which are not prime are called composite. So, the smallest composite number is 4. Composite numbers start from 4, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, up to infinity. These all are composite numbers. The smallest composite number is 4. I hope that you all may have known deliberately. So listen carefully and all the terms one by one. Now come on the next point, co-prime numbers. Co-prime numbers, the two numbers having HCF 1 are called co-prime numbers. It is not essential that in two co-prime numbers both will be prime number. It should be composite also. Example, 9 and 14. You know, 9 and 14 both are composite, but combinedly this is called co-prime number, because if you find the HCF of 9 and 14, then we find 1 is the HCF of 9 and 14. So this pair is called co-prime numbers. The two numbers having their HCF 1 is called co-prime number. Example, 9, 14. Second example, 3, 5. Next example, 5, 7, etc. Now, come on rational numbers. In class 9th, you may have studied in the first chapter, number system, about the rational numbers. Rational numbers are represented in the fractional form, like in p by q, either x by y, either m by n, in any fractional form. But the condition is both numerators and denominators should be integers, and denominator must not be zero. But the question is now, is zero a rational? Obviously, zero is rational because zero means zero by one. And you see here, zero is numerator and one is denominator. So, as zero numerator, this is rational number. We have studied about the rational numbers. Rational numbers are of two types. First is positive rational number and second is negative rational number. Positive rational number. In positive rational numbers, numerator and denominator either should be positive, either negative. Example, 2 by 3 is positive rational number, 3 by 4 is positive rational number, and also minus 2 upon minus 3 is also positive rational number. Minus 3 upon minus 4 is also positive rational number. But in negative rational number, either numerator should be negative or denominator should be negative. That is, only one from both of them should be negative. Example, minus 3 by 4 is negative rational number. 7 by minus 5 is negative rational number. So these are the rational numbers. Now, second is irrational numbers. The numbers which cannot be represented in the p by q form. So, we can define it differently. The numbers which are in the form of a square root, but inside the square root, the number is not perfect square. Example, root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6, root 7, root 8. These all are irrational numbers. But according to class 9th, I had explained in the class that any rational number can be represented in two forms, terminating and non-terminating. Terminating is in the form of whose denominator will be in the form of 2 to the power m or 5 to the power n or both. But non-terminating has two parts, non-terminating repeating and non-terminating non-repeating. Non-terminating repeating is also called rational, but if we take the example of non-terminating non-repeating, that is irrational. So the value of pi that Ramanujan found is also irrational, because if we find the value of pi in the decimal form, this is non-terminating, non-repeating, so we can say that the pi is also irrational. Otherwise, except pi, all non-terminating, non-repeating are called irrational numbers. Some examples of irrational numbers are, just I had given you, but some are also root 11, root 12, root 13, root 14, root 16 will be the rational number. So I hope that you all will be understood about the irrational numbers. Now, rational and irrational both are combinedly called real numbers. So those numbers which are rational as well as irrational are called real numbers. So all rational are real, but all real are not rational. All irrational are real, but all real are not irrational. So these were the fundamental terms related to this chapter. Now come on the subject matter. In this chapter, firstly I want to explain the Euclid's division lemma, that is also called Euclid's division algorithm. First of all, I want to tell you, Euclid was the Greek mathematician who gave a fact that can be used to find the SCF of two and more than two numbers, that is popularly known as Euclid's division lemma. Euclid was a mathematician, but the question is, what is Euclid's division lemma? To listen, the statements of Euclid's division lemma is, for any two positive integers, like a, where a and b both are, So students, try to understand about the Euclid's division lemma, which is also known as Euclid's division algorithm. The statement of this lemma is, for any two positive integers a and b, here a and b both are positive integers, there exists a unique integer q and r satisfying the relation a equal to bq plus r, where 0 is less than r, 0 is less than equal to r, and r is less than b. This is a condition. In junior class, you may have studied about the verification of division, ki dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So Euclid's division lemma is based on that fact. Here Euclid took a as dividend, b as divisor, q as quotient, and r as remainder. So this lemma is also based on the proof of division fact that you may have studied in junior class. For verification of any division, at last we do, our division is right or wrong, we prove it. How we prove? Firstly, we multiply divisor by quotient and then we add remainder. If it becomes dividend, then I understand that division is right. So Euclid division lemma
here is the hypothesis for any two positive integers, a and b, both are positive integers. There exist unique integers, that is two integers will come, q and r, that a, b and q r satisfy the relation a equal to bq plus r.